beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. My name is Titilayo, and if this is your first time seeing me on your screen or stopping by on my channel, it is very nice to meet you or welcome. If this is not your first time, you know the drill. A one, a two, you're welcome, welcome back. How is everyone doing? I hope everyone is having a wonderful, fabulous, beautiful day. So in today's video, as you guys can tell from the title, I spent a truckload of money changing my entire vlogging system. Just a little recap on what my old vlogging system used to be and why I needed a change. I was using a Sony A5100. This camera was an absolutely beautiful camera. I felt like for the purpose and intent of starting out vlogging, this camera definitely came in handy. It was an absolute OG when it first came out, still is. And this camera was pretty much a compact mirrorless camera. I absolutely love this because vlogging for me was definitely something that I had to become adapted to. I'm still trying to learn how to be adapted to it. I still get awkward going outside with a huge camera and trying to like do things inconspicuously, so you know, I'm not that obvious. So having the A5100 was definitely a plus because it's as huge as your smartphone and you can definitely hold it in places and people won't even know you have a camera on you. You definitely don't feel it in your hand because it's super, super light. However, the only thing is, as my quality started to increase on my channel generally, I felt like my vlogging quality was still kind of left behind. I'm trying to incorporate a lot more vlogs in my channel as a whole, and so I felt like to do that properly, I needed to have the system to do that and the setup to do that. So I'm not going to speak too much. I'm just going to show you guys what my current system looks like, take you through the things that I actually purchased, and let you guys know why I purchased it. And I'm not a tech guru, you know, I'm not one of those people who would tell you the aperture of this is this, 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 none of that. I mean, I understand those things, but I know it's hard for some people to understand. So to kind of help with this video and seeing how these things work, I decided to take them into the field, like literally film vlogs with them. And so this video has incorporated with it about 3 vlogs that you can see. You know, I tested out different things so you guys can see what, you know, you might want and what you might not want. All right, so without further ado, let's get on into the things that I bought. That I picked up is the Sony a6400. Now this camera is actually a camera that came out very recently, I think towards the beginning of 2020 or late 2019. I'm not really sure on the release date, and it's actually supposed to be an upgrade to the a6300, which has been out for like a couple of years now from Sony. So when I watched the release video, what I understand is they decided to bring out this camera as an upgrade because it does have the flip up screen. Now the mechanism isn't the greatest, it looks kind of tacky, but it gets the job done. You can actually see yourself. Also, this camera records in 4K very easily, even compared to my actual main DSLR camera. It records 4K very easily and in small sizes. So I also picked up an SD card. I picked up a 128GB SD card. I tend to rack up a lot of footage, and I used to have like 32 gigs or 64 gigs, and it's just like every footage is everywhere. So right now it's easy because I can just have all of my footage in one card and it just makes my life easier. So I also picked up a protective screen for this camera as well. I'm trying to actually, you know, take good care of it so I don't want the screen to get scratched or anything. One of the functions that this camera has compared to the other cameras, like the A5100 that I was using, is it also comes with a mic jack. After vlogging with this camera and going back to watch my other videos, was I had really poor audio. And really poor audio in the sense that it was okay because you guys could always hear me, like I project myself just so the camera can actually catch my words. However, when I'm talking to people or when I'm trying to shoot people, when I'm trying to like video people who do not know how to speak in front of a camera properly for them to be heard, who are just like, you know, doing their own thing, or I'm trying to get you guys to hear something, you're just hearing everything. So it's really hard because it's picking up on all of the sounds. And the built-in microphone for the camera on that A5100 was definitely not it. So I did pick up a microphone. I picked up the Mookie microphone. I love the fact that it has the dead cat as well to be able to help me filter out the noises. And you would hear when I'm speaking in the vlogs that you can actually hear me clearly, like even in a place where I was, because I did go to a barbecue with this, and you would actually be able to hear me clearly. You can hear like my voice over the music. It's even hard to hear the music in the background, and I feel like absolutely needed. Like, that's like, it's going to take my vlogs to a whole nother level, just having perfect audio. One of the specs of the camera is that, and this is kind of a con to the camera, is that it doesn't have the optical image stabilization. Now, I know that that's a huge, you know, statement, and what it pretty much means is normally your camera, or most cameras, would have a system built into them to actually help you steady your shots, so like it's not jumbling and moving all over the place. So if your camera has that, that's fine. It actually would help. Again, remember, you're vlogging, so regardless, your hand is still going to have those movements. But however, the fact that you're actually, you know, with a camera that has the optical image stabilization built in, it would reduce it more than what it's supposed to be like on a normal day. The A6400 is not one of those cameras with optical image stabilization. That's a con for me, because, you know, you're using it for vlogs, you want to be able to steady your shots. So I don't always want my vlogs, you know, moving up and down. I don't want my videos shaky. You would see it in the vlog that I'm about to show you guys, how shaky the footage was. It made it a little bit hard to watch for me, honestly. So I didn't really like that. And also, the lens that I got for this, the Sigma 16mm lens, also does not have optical image stabilization. So at least if the camera didn't have it, the lens could have it and kind of help out my situation. But none of them have it. So that just made my life even, you know, more stressful. So I decided to go ahead and pick up a gimbal. And before I show you guys the specs of the gimbal and what the footage looked like with the gimbal, I'm going to quickly show you guys this vlog that I made at the beach without the gimbal.
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do, 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 so boom.
You can see in that vlog, the footage looks absolutely amazing. The A6400 is definitely a beautiful camera, especially with that Sigma lens mounted upon. The bokeh effect is like to the 100, but it was so hard to watch because of how shaky it was. Like, even when I steadied my hand to do like the pan movement, you could still see the shake. It's just crazy. So that's where this gimbal came in. So I picked up a gimbal. The gimbal that I picked up at first was the Fitek G Plus. Here's what it looks like. Here's what the insides look like. It was actually my first time trying out a gimbal ever. I've seen people use one. I know that it's all about balancing. So the whole point of it is it balances the weight of your setup on the gimbal. And once you turn it on, it has like an engine inside of it that would actually keep it balanced. So no matter how much you move your hands, no matter how much you walk, I mean, you have to still be reasonable and not like try to throw it up and expect it to still be balanced. But if you make reasonable movements with this, it would actually keep it focused and balanced on you. So I watched a lot of videos with people using this, and I decided to pick one up, and that was the setup that I used at the barbecue that I'm about to show you guys.
Why is this thing tilting?
Are you possessed?
I thought you would open the door.
Are you vlogging? What? Why are you like this? Oh, this is so. Say hi to the vlogging. Damn you! Did you just? I'm going to put it in there. Shall you say hi?
Hi.
I'm going to put it in there so they can see how rude you are. Say hi to the vlog.
What's up, Titi's vlog?
Hi.
We out here. We out here.
Say hi to the vlog.
Hi. I'm the ghost.
We at the grill, y'all. Say hi to the vlog.
What's up?
What's up, vlog?
Chill, anyhow.
Guys, I'm sure food. Hey, wait.
Let's try this.
Look at that, look at that.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to TT Talks TV.
Okay.
You're reaching out to a man like Andrew, okay. You know what I'm saying?
Hello.
Welcome, you're welcome.
Yeah, I'm her friend from Kenya. Cause we the best or whatever, but you know, it's okay. It's okay. I love her.
It's cool.
Y'all should subscribe. If you don't subscribe,
like, share, subscribe, comment, you know.
Y'all are not doing it right. Subscribe.
Hi.
Hi guys. Welcome to the barbecue.
Blessings, brother.
Hi.
What's up? You know what I'm saying? You know the vibes.
We can
hear you. Vibes.
Barbecue vibes.
City, I'm leaving. City, I'm leaving. I'm leaving. Let's tell people that are here for the first time. You are welcome.
Let's go. You guys should sing my welcome song.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Hey, you're welcome.
I don't know.
That's a loyal subscriber.
She's welcome.
She's welcome. She's welcome. She's welcome.
She ignored me first of all, but that's alright because she's my sister.
I have
sister
to put you up here so we can see you.
Don't touch it.
Hey, Granny Annie Gatsby.
We're in the building. Check out City Talks, or you get the
shout out to your Insta.
Sissy Winers. So we're still in the building for the rule and the crew. Tell them some
Gatsby TV.
See, if you don't subscribe. You'll be what? Inscribed.
Hey, leave me.
You can feel it in the streets. On a day like this, the heat, I feel like summer. It feels like summer.
I say you should call me. I say you call me, Popo. Baby, Bubbles, you know what I'm saying? One man still. Call me what? Bubbles, baby.
That's your new nickname, Bubbles.
No more. I make Bubbles look sexy, you know what I'm saying? No more. Sissy, point my head. See what I want to bust this. Bubble. Man, like Andrew busting Bubbles still.
Okay, guys, so that was the barbecue. My friends are absolute geeks. I love them all. But yeah, so that was the setup, and I don't know, I probably cut them out of the video, a lot of them, but I made sure to insert some parts where you can actually see the gimbal malfunction and just like switch over to one side or flip, or where I was actually complaining about it flipping. That was an issue ongoing with this. And the thing is, once the gimbal is turned on and the engine is working, you actually can't move your camera around. Like, you can't like try to manually set it to look at something. It's doing the work for itself. It's like automatic. So my biggest peeve was the fact that if I'm in a setting where I'm trying to capture good footage and my gimbal flips to the side and I can't move it back immediately to get that footage and I lose it, I would be pissed. I would lose it, legit. So I started to research to see why the gimbal was malfunctioning, because after I balanced it, it actually worked well for a couple of hours. And some people said, oh, it was the battery that wasn't that good. But then I found out the mistake that I made, because the G Plus Fitech gimbal can only take about 750 grams. And my camera itself, the A6400, weighs about 400 and something grams. The lens itself, the Sigma 16mm that I was using, also weighs about 450 grams as well. In total, my setup was reaching like the late 800 grams. And this thing can only take 750 grams. And I did have a mic as well on the camera. So what I decided to do was I exchanged that gimbal and got another gimbal from the same company that has a higher payload. So here's what my current setup looks like. And this is the new gimbal that I got. It's the same one, but it's the G Max. It can take up to 2 kg. Yeah, up to 2 kilograms. And that's a lot compared, that's a lot of give, because the setup itself is only about, let's say, 800 or like maybe 900 grams. And this can take up to 2 kilograms. So here's what it looks like. I've already balanced this off camera. To be honest, balancing it was a lot. It took a lot out of me. But that's what it looks like. It's not currently turned on now. And I'm just going to turn it on so you guys can see what happens when I turn it on. Alright. So when I turn it on, the screen comes on and it faces, like, you know, it starts to balance itself. And that's what it looks like. So again, like I said, see, I can't move it because the thing is just doing its own thing. If you try to move it too much, it would actually, like, spoil the gimbal. So you just let it do its thing. And I'm still trying to learn how to use the gimbal, but I've tested out some shots with it. I'm also going out today and I'm going to be taking the gimbal as well as the camera with me just to kind of practice with it and show you guys what the new setup looks like. But I feel like just with the ones I've done within my house after I set it up, it's definitely a lot better feeling and working with than the other gimbal. So while I have the setup in my hand, I'm just going to take you guys around the rig because everything that I bought is also on here. So one thing that I had to get was this rig right here, this one right here. Now what that rig was is a replacement rig because the microphone hot shoe jack is right on top, and once you put the microphone there, it absolutely hides the entire flip-up screen, which defeats the purpose of having a flip-up screen, right? So the replacement jack is something that a lot of people have implemented, so you can replace, you can mount it there, but it brings the replacement, it brings like a hot shoe mount on this side where you can put your mic, and that's what I had to do. I also have the kit lens for this, but honestly, I haven't tried the camera with the kit lens just because I have been loving on the Sigma 16mm lens. So maybe I might take some shots with the kit lens, who knows. But right now, I just have the kit lens for, you know, maybe if I'm traveling or if I have a shoot where I need to zoom in and zoom out, I can do that. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about the footage that I'm about to show you guys. And I'm absolutely loving this vlog setup. I feel like my vlogs going on from now would be absolutely amazing. And that just makes me even more motivated to do them. But yeah, thank you guys so much. Let me know if you have any questions regarding any of these things in the comment section. I would leave links to where you can purchase them in the description bar as well. So make sure to check those out if you're interested. And yeah, I will see y'all in my next video. God willing. Stay blessed and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye. Another banda. I'm in love with plenty women. I know my money, all of them. Hello. Get in my room, make you let down. Body, they move like a python. Oh, hey. Would they give me a yawn? What are you saying? Hello. Hey, oh, echo. Long story short, I couldn't do a lot of the vlogging like I wanted to today for a couple of reasons. So after I picked up Daba, yeah, we came over to her place and we actually went out because we're having a date tomorrow. Daba is taking me out on a date, or hosting me on a date. And so we went out to do a lot of shopping, and I was hoping that, you know, I could take out the camera and vlog during the whole shopping experience. But nah, I couldn't, because first of all, we had a lot of things to carry, and second of all, it started raining and I can't take my camera out. Well, I can take my camera out and just risk the camera, you know, because I'll be holding it, but I actually can't take out the gimbal in the rain because it's not water resistant. And so everything was in the car and we just did a lot of shopping, y'all. We shopped a lot. Let me see if I can plug you guys and show you guys what we got. See, Daba. Daba, say hi. All right, so look at those bags, guys. That's everything that we got. Wine like a snake. Let's go. But yeah, guys, so Daba is actually, like I mentioned, she's starting a day for me tomorrow, and we're doing a seafood boil. I'm so excited. I'm not going to do it in this particular video with the gimbal, but as you guys can see, I think it's, you know, it's working really well. It's up to me now to learn how to use it. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching and see ya. Say bye. Watch out for the seafood boil vlog. All right, guys. All right. You can feel it.